Welcome to another tutorial in MATLAB. In this tutorial series, we are looking into the concept of MAAB guidelines. And this is an intro video for the MAAB guideline. So let's see like what is a MAAB guideline and how we can do all the checks in our model to develop an efficient model. So as we discussed last time in the last video, that MAAB guideline stands for MATLAB Automotive Advisory Board. So the Automotive Advisory Board created this particular guidelines so that you can follow the guidelines and create most efficient models in MATLAB. These are some setup rules which you can follow and will not misguide you when you create the models. The first stage of any model development is the development of requirement documents. So at this stage, we usually get a document which describes what is the model about. So basically, these are some of the functionalities like cruise control system or adaptive suspension system or any image detection system. So these are different tools, but all those tools will be running some software in the hardware or in the processor. And those softwares need to be designed with the help of some requirement. So these requirements define the boundaries of the software, which it should do or which it should not do. So requirement is all about that. And based on those requirement document, we do create models. So the second stage here is to develop models. So most of the modeling part, which we do create, it is at this stage, at model development stage. And at model development stage, we do use different blocks. These blocks could be either provided from the organizations by creating a library block, or it could be user-defined block, or it could be basic Simulink blocks. So the model development involves all those things. And once we do create the model, so suppose the model development is done, which is basically following this requirement document. So based on this requirement document, we do usually create these models. And once we have the model, so we do implement the guideline check. So the MATLAB advisory board usually gives a set of guidelines which you can do the checks on the model that you have created. But it is very difficult when you see the manual and check everything that you have developed and to correct it. So in case of model advisory check, what they have done is they have created some automated scripts in this. So they have some automated guideline checks which will run as a software, and it will scan everything that is developed inside your model, and it will tell you that what is wrong in the model based on the guideline. Along with that, what are the fixes that is the tool can do. So once you press on the fix button, then everything will be fixed based on that particular guideline. So every guideline will have a check, and based on that check, you will get the code or the script linked to the advisory board check. So we will see this in the next video. So what are the checks that are there, and how you can implement those checks. So these checks are automatic. So that will help you to do all the checks in one go, and it will not take much time. So that is how they are solving this problem. Next is the generation of code from the developed model. So if you follow the guidelines, then the MAAB guidelines will help you to develop a defined code. And the generated code then can be distributed by selecting a defined language. So in this case, you can select C, C++, and PLC. So PLC also will be there. And many other languages are there through which you can generate the codes. And then you can use the code into the hardware. So we have also a code generation tutorial series, if in case you want to have a look into that in this particular channel. Along with that, we have also shown like how these models are defined and how code looks like when we generate something from the model. So that is how these guidelines can be used. So it will be mostly being used once you develop the model and you perform the guideline checks. So once you perform the guideline checks, your model will be checked with all these checks, and then you can fix the model based on the guideline. So this is done automatically, so you don't need to know about all the guidelines, but it is very important to know about the guidelines in case there is no model advisory check for a particular guideline in a MAAB. So everything cannot be automated. Some of the things you need to take care by yourself. Those if we know, then only we can implement. Otherwise, it will be missed from the model development part. So in the coming video, we will see how these checks can be done and how you can open the model advisory guideline once you develop the model. So that is how this works. In case you are liking the channel, please consider subscribing. In case you have any comment or query, please let us know in the comment section. We will be happy to help you in understanding all these concepts so that you will get most benefit out of these tutorial series. That is the intention of creating this. So have a great day and happy learning MATLAB. Thank you.